morning and welcome to Beating the Odds. I am Ms. Moore, your facilitator for this presentation. And today we're going to talk about my short-term action project here at Brown. I'm currently a candidate with the iLead Metro RESA program. Today what I would like to do is present to you my presentation on improving and beating the odds with school attendance. I chose to use the CARE team and the attendance team because we directly see our at-risk learners each and every day. And my at-risk learners are our children that are in the RTI and SSC process or 504 in Brown Middle School. Our teams consist of Dr. Danny Smith, which is our 8th grade assistant principal, Nikki Bivens, our media specialist, Tasha Keller, counselor, Jaquise Combs, teacher of the year, and also connections chair. Attendance team is Lamont Mitchell, social worker Makia Holtz. Lamont Mitchell is the social worker, Makia Holtz is discipline clerk, Nelson Lattimore, our other counselor, Portia Jackson, our 7th grade chair. Also, Mrs. Kimyatta Owens, our parent liaison, and Mr. Eric White, our communities and schools coordinator. In 2017, Brown Middle School was identified as a Beat the Odds school, which we are very proud of here at Brown, under the tutelage of Ms. Tiana Crooms. Brown is now one of the 11 middle schools in the district that was removed from the focus list after 2 years of guidance with the state. Our CCRPI data has increased between 1 to 3 points each year in regards to exceeding the bar, also school climbing, utilizing SLDS, and growth in regards to student achievement with ELA and math. Functions of the attendance and care team. Though our duties kind of sink, we still all come together for a common good. We provide support with academics, behavior, and attendance. We utilize data to drive decisions for our students based on the severity of the case. As a team, we look at multiple banks of data, that's CCRPI, SAR data. We look at Phoenix benchmarks and et cetera. Also APSVs and Infinite Campus. In a collaborative setting, what we do is formulate a strategic plan to address concerns of our students to make it better for the success of all. Data snapshot. This is going to be a 3-year consistent pattern of our data at Brown Middle School. As you can see, in 2015, our CCRPI data reflects a consistent increase in growth, starting with our attendance at 72%. With our achievement, we were at 38.7, progress was 76.6, achievement gap is 10, challenge points is 1, and our overall score for that year was 65.3. The data snapshot from 2015-16 shows a 73% 1-point increase with the achievement of 18.8. Progress was at 33.3, achievement gap 5.8, challenge point was 1, with an overall score of 58.9. We did do a slight dip with our academics, but as you can see, our attendance increased. As of last school year, we increased again by 1 point to 74.4%. The achievement data, though, stayed consistent with 18.8 and progress with 3.3 and achievement with 5.8. We still remain fighting with the 1-point challenge with our SWD students and our at-risk students in the building. Our overall score stayed consistent at 58.9%. Just to dig a little deeper into the data, what I discovered with my research is, though our students show a trending pattern of 93.4%, our teachers diligently come to work. We have, over the last 3 years, shown a consistent pattern with our staff of 95.5%. The data snapshot for the cluster, as you can see, we tread maybe in the middle. Hollis having the highest, Tuskegee came next, and Brown was in the middle, with Washington following close behind. In August, out of 545 students, 12 of those students were 504. 45 of the students were in SST. As you can see, I have the data broken down by grade levels. Some of the plans of action that we're going to do to increase attendance will be to train teachers on RTI Infinite Campus that will help to increase the data with attendance. Train teachers on 504 and acknowledgement forms. Make sure each teacher and administrator has copies so that if we have issues with students with 504s that need to be properly coded, we will take care of that. Ensure all SST and 504 flags have been updated. We want to make sure that we train grade level directors on implementing tier two strategies with attendance, and also make sure that we're keeping up with calendar draft meetings on the school website. In September, we had a population, as you can see, it's increasing steadily of 578, with 15 students as 504, 43 in SST, and the data is broken down again by grade level. In September, we began planning and having SST and 504 meetings, meeting with the attendance team regularly, and also working diligently with Mr. Mitchell to implement attendance contracts. We also reached out to parents via letters, correspondence with emails and telephone calls, and etc. Here we are in October with our enrollment steadily increasing, which means our attendance is going up. Again, we're at 15 with 504, 43 with SST, RTI is 30. We are no longer showing that loss of enrollment. Kids are coming into the district now. We're constantly keeping up with Ms. Brown in the office. We're making sure that we're properly coding medical excuses with 504s and also any students that are at risk with SST and tier two. We want to make sure that kids are getting their hearing and visions, which also has a research-based link with students that tend to drop out. A lot of kids that we claim and we just all of a sudden say can't read, yes, they can. Some of them have issues with hearing and vision, so we're trying to make sure we're taking care of that. We're having the ongoing SST meetings. We're continuing to work with Mr. Mitchell and Mr. White for mentoring, along with putting in functional behavior plans for any students that we see have absences or tardiness throughout the day. Just a synopsis at this point, Brown has a total population as of October and as of 578 students. Out of the 578, the students make up 16% of the population with SST. Many of our students in the RTI process, they have various concerns, academics, behavior, and attendance. This year, the focus was attendance over the other two. So that brought me to the question of why aren't our kids coming to school? Some of the kids that I surveyed, their answers were they woke up late or missed the bus. Of course, suspension has been an issue. Medical illnesses, tardies, which in Infinite Campus, after three or more tardies, it constitutes one absence. And over the past 2 years, you can see that we have come extremely close to making 95% with our students, but we still tread at that 92. So our plan of action for this school year for a short-term process over a 20-day period will be to identify those kids in the SST process that have missed 3 days or more since the beginning of the school year. We want to invite parents and students to attend an attendance party. We'll, at that party, we'll explain the compulsory law also have them to sign the student handbook along with the attendance contract. We're going to provide with Ms. Owens rewards and incentives through the parent liaison with weekly raffles and family feud night. Plan of action four, we want to create a data board with Mr. Banger, which serves as our attendance facilitator to show praise and acknowledgments via morning announcements with Ms. Bivens. Our last plan of action would be to have contact with Ms. Brown, our school secretary, to make sure that medical and any other absent notices are properly coded. Now let's slam dunk our goal. Over the next 20 days, utilizing the interventions proposed in this presentation, it is the team's goal to raise our attendance by 1%. The long-term goal of this plan is to raise it with the overall score by 2% in the building. Brown CCRPI data, though it has still traded with our students at 90 to 93%, we are going to aim high and beat the odds for the 2017-18 school year. At this time, do I have any questions from the attendance or care team committee? Thank you again. It has been my pleasure being your facilitator this morning. Again, I'm Ms. Moore. I serve as your student support team, RTI specialist in the building. Thank you for coming. Thank you.